Hanson brought us the first chapter in Eric Hanson's story last year. Tonight he brings us the rest of the story.
When Duncan Cameron started restoring a relic,
the Marine Corps called it an OY-1.
He had no idea flight logs would lead him to a pilot.
I got down to Merton P. Hanson.
I was 90 years old in June.
One of the only surviving men who flew planes like this over Iwo Jima.
Now I got my hearing aids covered up. Now let's go.
But Mert's thrill ride on a plane like his last summer was nothing compared to the news Duncan had just found Mert's actual plane.
This one is it.
But it wasn't pretty, and Mert wasn't getting any younger.
I says, well, I'll give you 3 years to get it finished so that I can fly it.
You know, I gotta get this done. I don't have a choice. I have a responsibility.
Thousands of hours later,
he redid this one in a perfect manner.
Now 91-year-old Mert touched the very metal.
Think of it, over 70 years.
He'd flown in so many hostile missions.
I couldn't figure out why I was the only one left to see it.
The Tennessee pilot who meticulously restored Mert's plane right down to her war-era band-aids did all this for a humble Iowa veteran.
Who would ever fix something up that you'd mashed up 70 years ago?
A hero who'd smile through one gentle turn, then well up with emotion at the next, when he realized the only thing better than experiencing this moment with his gal,
all my life, I'll remember this,
is experiencing it with his wife.
How was it?
She flew nice.
Oh, good.
In Ankeny, Eric Hanson, News Channel 8.
That was great.
Iowa's News Leader.
That was great.
How cool is that? Duncan's year-long restoration of Mert's plane was so well done, he just won the top award at the National Aviation Heritage Air Show in Reno, Nevada. But he says the award's nothing compared to actually flying the plane with Mert today.
It's pretty special indeed, John. You're a pilot. I bet you exactly.